Hello everyone. Today I want to share about the Genesis chapter 10 and 11. In chapter 10, we can see genealogy of the Noah. He had three sons, Shem, Ham, Japheth. And then in chapter 10 also covered their sons. So Shem's son Shem had five sons. Ham had four, and Japheth had seven. They are the son of them. So, and then when the Bible talk about the Shem's family, the last verse is this one. These are the clans of the sons of Noah, according to their genealogies in their nations. And from these, the nations spread abroad on the earth after the flood. So after the flood, Shem's children scatter on earth as God commanded. And after Ham's sons' names, this is the last verse about their family. These are the sons of Ham by their clans, their languages, and their lands, and their nation. Japheth also had like this. From these, the coastland peoples spread in their lands, each with his own language and by their clan in their nations. So they scatters like this. Shem, this part, they scattered. Ham also scattered like this. And Japheth also scattered like this. Okay? Through these pictures, we can see that God's creation commandment, because after the flood, God commanded Noah like this, be fruitful and multiply and fill the earth. And then as you see, their sons scatter like this. They obeyed God's commandment. However, people multiplied and filled the earth and as God commanded them after the flood. However, they attempt to do as they want. That's the Tower of Babel in Genesis chapter 11. So we will see that Tower of Babel. The Bible tells that the condition was the one language. They used the one language and one people. And their purpose of building Tower of Babel was to reach the heavens and to live together, not scatter on earth. So we may ask, why is the Tower of Babel wrong? What's wrong with that? Why is it wrong? Because they wanted to live together, not scattered on earth. Why is it a problem? We have to remember Genesis chapter 9, verse 1. God commanded them to multiply and fill the earth. God didn't command them to gather together, live in the same place. God never commanded them to build the high tower to reach the heaven. So it means their effort, their attempt to build the Tower of Babel is a disobedience. So we have to remember God works according to his will. Okay? So his will was he wants that people be fruitful, multiply, and fill the earth. So to accomplish this will, what did God do when people build the Tower of Babel? He varied the languages and so they could scatter on earth. When they use one language, they attempt to build the Tower of Babel to reach the heavens and gather together. But God wants them be fruitful, multiply, and fill the earth. That's why. To accomplish that will, he varied the language. So, through the Tower of Babel, we can notice God's power. God has power to accomplish his will. Yes, he has. So, we should obey his commandment and fulfill it faithfully as is stored. God told scatter. And then we have to scatter. If God told gather, we have to gather, right? So we have options than to obey. That is the best option for us. And you remember that from Adam, he first time he had Abel and Cain, but Cain killed Abel. And then after that, God gave Adam the Seth. And then from Seth, Enosh come. Enosh was the generation to call upon the name of the Lord again. It's very important. And from him, we see that Enosh, he was really, really faithful and walked with God in all his life. And from that those generation, we can see the Noah also. Okay? And then Genesis, also after the flood, we see Noah. And then we know that Noah had three sons, right? Shem, Ham, Yabed. And then from them, Shem. From Shem, there were many generations after Shem. And then it reached to the Terah. And then you know who is Terah? He is father of Abram. And then you are familiar with the name Abram. Maybe Abraham. He will be Abraham. Anyway, he is Terah, is the father of the Abram. And his wife is Sarai. And then their story is very famous. So through this story, we can see God's history is connected to accomplish his will. Until now, we just read that Terah is the father of Abram. And then from Abraham, what would happen? If you read the Bible already, you know that. And in the end, what is the God's purpose? So we have to remember God's story is connected. But sometimes we just read Adam's story or Noah's story or Abraham's story, but they do not connect to each other, though it is connected. So I advise you, read the Bible as a whole. God is perfect to plan and implement his will accurately. When we read the Bible as a whole book, we can see the linkage among different stories in the Bible. Also, we can see the core message of the Bible and God's faithfulness to his promise. This is the reason that we should read the Bible as a whole. So, facing forward. Number one, we have to remember God accomplished his will. So, we have to obey his will as his steward. And then number two, God's story is connected. So, to know that how they are connected, to see the linkage of the every story, we need to read the Bible as a whole. Thank you very much.